Is the screen is visible? हेलो
हेलो नवीन,
स्टार्ट।
वी विल वेट फॉर 5 मिनट्स। आई थिंक ओनली 4 हैव जॉइंड।
ओके हाँ ओके ओके वी शैल वेट नो प्रॉब्लम वी
ओके।
शैल।
Naveen, you start, no problem. Okay.
ओके
Once the class is over, you just give end.
ओके हाँ
Okay. Okay. Continue.
ओके टुडे टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू सी अबाउट द सर्कुलेटरी सिस्टम्स इन इंसेक्ट। यूजुअली इन हायर एनिमल्स ब्लड ट्रैवल्स थ्रू स्पेशल वेसल्स कॉल्ड आर्टरीज एंड वेन्स, बट इन केस ऑफ इंसेक्ट्स इंसेक्ट्स हैविंग ओपन सर्कुलेटरी सिस्टम, इट्स नॉट क्लोज्ड वन, वेयर इन ऑल द इंटरनल ऑर्गन्स आर बाथिंग इन ब्लड इनसाइड द बॉडी कैविटी कॉल्ड हीमोसील, एंड द ब्लड ऑफ इंसेक्ट्स आर कॉमनली कॉल्ड एज हीमोलिम्फ which carries various functions of both the blood as well as lymph. In case of humans, if you see, blood and lymph will be separate. But here, the hemolymph is the only content which carries the function of both blood as well as lymph. If you see the body cavity, the body cavity is imperfectly divided into three large cavities, usually called as sinuses, namely pericardial sinus, perivisceral sinus and perineural sinus by two fibromuscular septa. Usually it is made up of muscles are called diaphragms, namely dorsal and ventral diaphragms. You can see here this is actually is of already told abdominal region is divided into three regions by means of two diaphragms. The three regions are pericardial sinus, it is in the topmost layer, it will be there, this and this topmost layer will be consist of this topmost layer will be consist of pericardial sinus and perivisceral sinus, and at the lower end you can see the perineural sinus. These two regions will be divided by means of two diaphragms. Here you can see the below the heart you can see the dorsal diaphragm. In here it is you can see the ventral diaphragm. In between these two regions only. You can see the pericardial, perivisceral, as well as perineural sinuses. And if you see the circulatory systems, the circulatory organs are present mostly in the pericardial sinus, and it will be held in position by means of some connective tissues or strands which attach to dorsal integument, insect integument, tracheal region, gut, and other organs, and by a series of paired, which usually of fan-shaped alary muscles. These alary muscles are usually present in the heart region. It will be present. We can see about it depthly in upcoming slides. Usually the circulatory system functions as the transport system for nutrients, hormones, metabolic waste, and it contains elements of immune system, insect immune system. And the main, the chief organ which is responsible for blood circulation in insects is a dorsal vessel, which this dorsal vessel is the chief organ for blood circulation, which is also supported by some accessory pumping structures, which present in near the wings, antenna, and the leg regions. The dorsal vessel usually runs along the whole length of the body, just below the tergum. Tergum is the dorsal part area of the insect abdomen, along with the medial dorsal line. You can see, if you take the insects, if you see the center, if you take the center line of insect, it is through the whole center line, this dorsal vessel will be running, since from the mouth area to until anus area. It is a continuous tube extending from the posterior region of abdomen to just beneath or behind the brain in head, especially between the corpora cardiaca. Wait a minute, I will show you the diagram. You can see this diagram. Actually, here, this is the posterior region. From this posterior region to anterior region, the posterior region here only, it's consists of heart. From here to anteriorly, here aorta, behind the brain. This whole length will be consist of the dorsal diaphragm. This dorsal diaphragm consists of the complete circulatory system. It functions with it is the place where the whole circulatory system functions. As I told, the dorsal vessel has the major two divisions, namely posterior. This posterior region is called the heart. This is called heart. This whole length, you can find the alary muscles here. These muscles are called alary muscles, and the anterior region is called aorta. This anterior region is called aorta. Or this aorta are called as conducting vessels, because from heart, what are all the blood will be pumped to aorta here. This aorta will conduct it to brain. From brain, whether it will be came written back or else it may be expelled for use of this antenna and other accessory pulsatile organs like in the leg region. And heart is perforated on the walls by valvar openings, are called as ostia. This is a heart. This is aorta, which joins here in the brain, which comes in the line of corpora cardiaca. This is actually this is the ostia. This opening is called as ostia. This which allows the hemolymph passage. This insect blood will pass inside this ostia only during the heart movements, during relaxation diastole and in these systole phases. Diastole will happen usually during relaxation of the heart, and the systole will happen usually in the contraction phase of the heart. And already I told, heart has a chambered appearance because of the constrictions between by some successive paired ostia and alary muscles. You can see the alary muscles already. You can see this is the alary muscles. This is the ischia opening. This through this opening only insect blood will come inside the heart, and this Allery muscles helps in the contraction and relaxation of the heart during circulation. On the either side of the heart, this wing shaped Allery muscles are the main organ which involved in this circulation process. As I told already, heart is constructed of mainly by of myocardial cells, the special cells. This so the cells which present in this heart region are called as myocardial cells. As like as human, usually a human as well as our insects systems nearly physiological system nearly matches. You can see in digestive system also. You can see in the respiratory systems also. So it's simple if you are remaining comparing it with human system. And next to heart is the aorta. Here I need to tell you the ischia. If you see in this ischia, you can see there is two types of ischia: incurrent ischia and excurrent ischia. This incurrent ischias are the small slit like paired openings which usually present in the lateral side, which is guarded with a flap called valvar flap, and it allows the hemolymph to enter in, as I showed you in this picture earlier. And it is usually 9 pairs in the abdominal regions, and it is 3 pairs in the thorax. Commonly, it is 12 pairs present in the insects. For example, Dictyoptera. In Dictyoptera cockroach, you can see 12 pairs. In some insects, the ischia usually like 2, 3, 4, 5, and the count will be varies in some insects. You can see here in many Lepidopterans, this is very important in exam point of view. You can make notes with this. In Lepidoptera, usually 7 or 8 ischia will be present. In case of bees, wasps, and ants, Hymenopterans, you can see 5 pairs. In case of houseflies and many other dipterans, it is 4 only. The ischia, only 4 ischia will be present. And in Heteropterans, you can see 2 or 3 pairs of ischia. And in lice also. You can see here, this is the ischia. This diagram here represents it is a microscopic view. Here once it is during contraction, diastole phase, you can see the opening of this ischia. The blood will come inside. During systole phase, it will close, hence the blood will flow directly to aorta, from heart to aorta. And another one important, pericardial cells. The important cells, these pericardial cells are nothing but these are cluster of cells or a string of cells. It will be in strings. It occurs in the external surface, above the external surface of heart. And its important function is to phagocytosis. If any foreign agents try to come inside, it will capture that. This pericardial cells. You can see the pericardial cells here. This is the heart, and this is the pericardial cells. This pericardial cells will be outside external surface of the heart. You can see this pericardial cells. Allery muscles, I told you already. Incurrent ischia is over. And if you see the next to heart, if you see in the anterior region, you can find the aorta. This aorta is the principal artery of the body, and it is a simple tube without any perforation. Here you can't see any ischias. You can't see any perforations there. Dorsal vessel usually continues as aorta in the thorax and terminates in the head near the brain, you can see in this picture. Here, this is heart region. Now, from this heart region, you can see this is aorta. Usually, this aorta won't have any ischials, and it will end near the brain. Here it ends in the brain. And aorta may divide at the end to form some cephalic arteries. The cephalic region is nothing but it is the fused region of mouth and head. There you can find some arteries which will connect to different organs. In addition to this aorta, aorta and heart for in the pumping activity of insects, some other accessory pulsatile structures which aid in the movement of hemolymph. Those accessory pulsatile organs are sac-like structures. These accessory pulsatile organs are like structure situated at the bases of wings and the legs and the antennas, and it usually pulsatile independently of heart. Without even some insect, if you see cockroaches, if you plug its if its heart is damaged, it can live for another 2 to 3 hours without the functioning of heart. This is the this is due to the presence of this accessory pulsatile organs in the wing region, or else in the leg region, or in the antenna. In many insects, it is in different places it will be located, and it will independently it will pulsatile, and it also plays an important role in hemolymph circulation. As I told earlier, this peristaltic contraction of dorsal vessel and this accessory pulsatile organ, along with the movement of some internal organs and abdominal ventilatory movements, that nothing but the while the muscle contraction of muscles in the abdominal regions and in the contraction of a heart and the pulsatory accessory pulsatile organs, the hemolymph will be circulated in the body. You know already, I told you, relaxation phase called a diastole. During this diastole phase, that ischial will be open, blood will come inside. During the contraction phase, it will close again. It's called systole. The blood will be expelled over the anterior region, in the aorta. And the circulation time difference in different insects, usually it is 3 to 10 minutes. This circulation will happen. And the frequency of heartbeat in insects varies among insects. Usually in the earlier larval instar, it will be heartbeat will be more, and in the late instar the heart will be less. In some insects in the pupal stages there will be no heartbeats also. In the pupa of Anagasta cuneiella, the heartbeat is 6 to 11 times per minute. In case of larval Blatta graminica, it is the cockroach, the rate will be heartbeat will be 180 to 310 beats per minute. The hemolymph is pumped anteriorly, as I told, the dorsal vessel, and it exits. That blood should be excess. No, it will take place by means of excurrent ischia. I told two types of ischia there. One is incurrent ischia and excurrent ischia. The incurrent ischia will brings the blood inside, but the excurrent ischia will bring the blood outside. And in many insects, the hemolymph enters the wing. The wing region will be there, no? For flying of wings, and the wing need hemolymph circulation. For this, the hemolymph will enter through the anterior veins, and it also returns to the thorax via anal veins. The hemolymph will enter in wing through anterior veins, and it will came back and returns to the thorax region by means of anal vein. In some lepidopteran and coleopterans, the tidal flow of hemolymph occurs in the wing, which means nothing but the hemolymph will flow in both directions. It will come simultaneously into inside the vein, and the hemolymph will go outside the vein immediately. So this is called tidal flow. It can be seen in the some coleopteran and lepidopteran insects. These are the basic circulation aspects which happens in the insect circulatory system. Apart from this, the important thing is the insect blood or hemolymph. For exam point of view, this insect blood or hemolymph, they will ask some in-depth questions also. The hemolymph, first of all. The insect blood accounts for nearly 15 to 75% of volume of insects. The insect volume is composed of nearly 15 to 75% by means of hemolymph. It contains the liquid plasma and the blood cells, which is called as hemocytes. It is usually, this hemolymph is usually colorless. But in case of some insects, due to the presence of some pigments, the color may be green, yellow, or blue colored. The red hemolymph, usually like humans, the red hemolymph is, can be noticed in some midges, chironomid midges, this bot flies, horse bot flies, and in some back swimmers. This is the reason because of this red color is the presence of hemoglobin, like humans. The hemolymph constitutes around 5 to 40% of total body weight of insects. Weight, in case of weight, it contributes to 5 to 40%. In case of volume, it will be 15 to 75%. Don't confuse the both. And if you see the pH of the insect hemolymph, it usually lies between 6.4 to 6.8. Some authors, they will mention it as 7 to 7.5. Usually, this 7 to 7.5, it's everywhere. It's given in every book. I have referred, I made this reference from Chapman book. Liquid plasma usually consists of insect inorganic ions, lipids, sugars, amino acids, proteins, some organic acids also. Usually, the blood sugar of insects is a non-reducing disaccharide called trehalose. This is very, very important. The blood sugar of insects, they will, in exams, every exam they used to ask trehalose. Trehalose is a blood sugar. It's a non-reducing disaccharide. It's not a reducing one. It's a non-reducing. You need to remember this. Since if you see in some high altitude living insects, like for example, in the insects which lives in the Himalayan regions, the diplurans, the mostly the diplurans which will be living in the high altitude regions, these insects will have the special anti-freezing agents called glycerol. Apart from glycerol, some other agents like sorbitol also present, and sorbitol and mannitol. And another one chemical called malodorous, M-A-L-O-D-O-R-U-S, malodorous. It is a chemical responsible for distasteful of some insects. For example, some insects will make them distasteful for protection from other group enemies, natural enemies. And it, this malodorous is a chemical which is responsible for this distastefulness. Usually the hemolymph becomes distasteful manner. Normally, if you see in predators, there will be high level of sodiums will be present. In case of parasites, there will be a high range of magnesium can be seen. But in the phytophagous insects, potassium will be more, and the chemical exchange and the hormone transports are usually carried out by means of hemolymph only. The hemolymph plays the major role in this hormone transport. If you see the corpora cardiaca, it is the storage organ where the hormones will be stored. This corpora cardiaca is supported by circulatory system. And also hemolymph provides a protection from physical injury and entry of disease-causing bacteria, some parasites. Hemolymph clot is formed usually to seal those wounds in case of any injuries happen. Blood cells are hemolytes, maybe of various types and shapes. Usually it's of like human blood cells. There are different types of hemocytes can be seen. And the number of these blood cells varies among insects. It will range usually between 25,000 to 1 lakh per millimeter cube. Per cubic millimeter, we can see nearly 25,000 to 1 lakh. If we can see some different types of hemocytes, the blood cells, it will usually choose to change appearance time to time in same insects during different growth stages. You can see the types like prohemocyte, plasmocyte, granulocyte, spirulocyte, and the main important three cells like coagulocyte, adipohemocyte, or eosinophils. These eosinophils are different from eosinocytes. You don't confuse with this eosinophils and eosinocytes. Eosinophils are present in the cuticle, and it helps in the during the molting process. But the eosinophils are not. It's different. It's these are blood cells, insect blood cells. First one we can see the prohemocyte. These prohemocytes are the smallest, and this is the stem cell. from which all other blood cells are formed. Usually it is round. You can see in the photo, it's a picture. So round, and its nucleus is the largest nucleus among all cells. It's nearly, it contributes to 70 to 80%, and its size usually ranges from 6 to 13 micrometer. It contains mitochondria, ribosomes, and it is usually immobile. It won't, it can't able to move. And its function is to divide and to produce other hemocytes. It is like a mother cell. From this only other blood cells will be produced. Now next one, if you see, is the plasmatocytes. These plasmatocytes are usually large to, small to large, and it is polymorphic. It will be in different forms. It won't stay in one perfect form. Sometimes it may be round, sometimes it may be granular, and usually it will changes from a round shape to spindular shape in some cases based on the instant growth stages. And you can see numerous of this plasmatocytes circulating here and there in the blood hemolymph. And it's the main function it carries are phagocytosis. It's prevent the entry of foreign agents into the body. And even if a foreign agent comes inside, it will encapsulate it, and it will form nodules. And it also helps in wound healing. Next one is granulocyte. The granulocyte, from the name itself, we can see the shape of this cells will be like a granular form. And its size is varying. In some insects, it will be less than 45 micrometer. In some insects, it will be more 45 to 50 micrometer. And the nucleus is very small nucleus. And the main function is it will store and it secrete and it phagocytes. Phagocytes the foreign agents. It is abundant in Lepidoptera. This is very important point. Please note it. It is this granulocyte is present highly in Lepidopteran group of insects. And it's related with immunity in mosquitoes. Next one is spirulocyte. These spirulocytes are the ovoid or round shaped cells. It is usually a small one, and it contains of a small round spherical inclusions. These are the small spherical inclusions we can see inside the cell, and it also functions in phagocytosis. Mostly these hemocytes are the main function is of encapsulation and phagocytosis. And adipohemocytes, it's a very important one. It's usually small in some insects, and some insects it may be spherical to oval. And it contains the liquid droplets. Adipo means adipocyte cells. These are the lipid cells. These will be like a liquid droplets. You can see like a droplets. It will be filled inside this. And next one is eosinophils. These eosinophils are different from eosinocytes. You should not confuse. Eosinophils are different and eosinophils are different. It also varies size between different group of insects, but usually it is a binucleate cell, and it can lyse easily. It can be if you are using an enzyme, it can be lysed easily. And the many insects, if you see the insects which are a contact poison, they will react in these eosinophils soon. And it contains of the enzyme called prophenyloxidase. It helps in the circulation in the insect blood circulation. As I told earlier, it is different from eosinophils of fat body cells and epidermis. And the coagulocytes are nothing but these are the colorless hyalin hemocytes and are also called as cystocytes. It causes coagulation immediately once the injury or any external aberrations happens in the insect cuticle. So these are the major types of insect cells. And apart from this, the hemocyte contains two types of cells called as nephrocytes. Already I told the pericardial cells. These pericardial cells are also called as nephrocytes. And another one is eosinophils. We have seen the eosinophils. These nephrocytes are, wait a minute. Here you can see this pericardial cells. These pericardial cells are also known as nephrocytes. This nephrocytes are seen near the dorsal vessel, and it functions as ductless glands, and it also helps in excretion. Excretion means there are different types of excretions we have seen. You may go through in one type of respiration. One type of excretion takes place by means of this nephrocytes, and another one is eosinophils. This eosinophils occurs in the fat body. This fat body region is there now. Here only this eosinophils will be present, and it plays important role in lipid synthesis. This eosinophils helps in the formation of one of the layers of epicuticle. The lipoprotein layer of epicuticle will be formed by means of eosinophils only, and it also helps in the hemoglobin production in some insects like Chironomid midges and botflies. And some points regarding heartbeat. The heartbeat is usually myogenic origin. They will in some books they have mentioned in objective books the heartbeat is of both myogenic and cholinergic origin. Like this they have given, it's not both, it's only myogenic in origin. And as you see seen earlier, systole, diastole, everything. And apart from the systole and diastole, there is a third phase of heart movement is there. This is the after the systole, the third phase of the heart cycle is known as diastasis, in which the heart remains in the expanded state. It will be in the expanded state for some minutes. This is the third stage. It may be new to you, or else you just remember this one. In case in exams they may ask also, you should not confuse with the diastole and diastasis. And the rate of heart variables, as I told earlier, in some insects are based on the movement of the heart muscles. And the heartbeat usually increases with the temperature. If the temperature increases, the heartbeat also increases. So the metabolism of insect goes very soon. That's all. Anybody having any doubt, please ask me. Hello. Students, if you are having any doubts, please ask me. Sure, I will share the PPTs of today as well as yesterday. Actually, these PPTs are not the basics ones. I have prepared for some presentation, and it's consist of many foreign author based materials. So only I have doesn't show you some slides. Those are not there is no need for reading that much for JRF. Okay, I will share you that PPT to ma'am. You can take that and you can see some. The points are very useful points. The last year in exams, in SRF exams itself, they have asked from these materials only. I will share you. And in for exam purpose, exam view, please list out these types of cells and its functions. It's very important. And apart from that, this dorsal vessel, you just remember the diagram. How to remember the circulatory system is to remember the diagram from the posterior heart to anterior aorta. In between, what are the ischias present? What are the muscles, alveolar muscles present? And then how the pumping process going on? This you need to be remembered. In case if they are asking part A, part B type of question, like assertion and reason type, you should not be confusing. So just to remember the diagram. If you are remembering the diagram, answer will come automatically. Sometimes the anterior and posterior will be confusing. Anybody having doubt, please ask me. I will share the material soon. Objective book, if you see, now if people are in final year or else in third year, everyone here, those who are attending the class now, Pranaya. Okay. You're in the final year. If people are in final year, just first
Oh, sir,
you
third year.
third year. Okay. First I will tell for final year students because they are with less time, no? Then I can tell for the third year students. Actually, the final year students, after you people are completing with this basic fundamental books like Insecta, Principles of Applied Entomology, Applied Entomology by D.S. Reddy, these books, you need to go through with a book called AgriFact, Agricultural Entomology, Objective Agricultural Entomology. The author name is S.V. Sai Prasad. It is not T.V. Prasad. T.V. Prasad is different. S.V. Sai Prasad. Actually, this book consists of 30 model questions for entomology. Every model paper will have 50 questions. Like this 30 set question will be there. And apart from this nematology, they will provide with 10 sets, same 50 questions, and general agriculture 10 set. This book is very, very useful book because this book has been written, the questions in this book has been given by different scientists in different research institutes, those who are working in different institute. So this, you can, it will be helpful to you. And the mistakes, the some in many books, the questions will be, they are given wrong answers and wrong questions. In this book, there is very, very little, very minimum questions are like that. That too, while you are reading itself, you will understand which that whether that answer is wrong or not. So first follow that book, AgriFact, Objective Entomology by S.V. Sai Prasad. And after you are go through in this book, so there's you can daily take one set question paper, 50-50 questions daily. And then you can go with another book called Agriculture Entomology by, wait a minute. I will show the book now in video, you can see. Actually, you can see the book here, Agricultural Entomology by Dr. Sharvan M. Halder. Actually, this book is for SRO preparation also. You used to prepare this book. It's a very, very nice book. It consists of entomology part, nematology part, and as well as of pathology part. You can go through entomology, nematology part alone. Actually, in entomology part, nearly 1,000 questions will be present in this book with some revising points also. It will be very useful. You can use this book. And the book, another book I have told you, I will show. This is the book what I have told, AgriFact, Agricultural Entomology by S.V. Sai Prasad. He is the main author. This book actually consists of 30 set of see the list of authors. You can see different authors from different research institute probably have given this. You can see nearly 30 model questions will be there for entomology and for 10 for nematology and 10 for this general agriculture will be there. It's a very nice book. Surely you can get this and you can read this book. In case for third year students, first you start reading the basic fundamental books. The Insecta is for morphology, taxonomy, and then physiology. That book is more than enough. After you are reading this book, you can go with treatise by T.V. Prasad. That book, the treatise is like a revision material. This is for final years also. Once you are completing one topic, specific topic, for example, if you are reading the morphology part in Insecta or any materials, what you are having in UG materials or anything, once you have completed, then pass on to this morphology part in the treatise by T.V. Prasad. It will be very useful for revision. The questions will be mostly framed based on these books only. And some people may know about, final year students may know about this refresher. If you feel very tough to take this refresher book, then just leave it and follow this treatise alone. It's more than enough. That will be enough for that. Okay, any other persons having any doubts? Anyone, final year or third year? Okay. Shall we close the class right now? Okay. Bye for everyone. From everyone, I will share this PPT to ma'am. For Lakshmi ma'am, you can get from ma'am. Okay. Thank you for everyone.